some slight adjustments to it, but it's pretty similar to what we were using before. The whole idea is that it's just a lot of spells, spell damage, and then you just slam down Yorg at the end and hope for the best. Which, I mean, it's not a complicated deck to use, but it's just kind of quite good fun. I've played a few games with it and tend to be kind of winning more than I'm losing, but quite frankly, there's a lot of randomness involved. Specifically, one game, I was pretty much on the brink of losing and then suddenly slammed down Yogg-Saron and won the game. It was it's a very strange game. Yeah, you know what, we'll take that. Sure, why not? So, you know, it's the sort of thing where just like one spell that Yogg casts, you know, differently, and that's it, you lose. It over, I think, see what he's got, because we could either Frostbolt or Loot Order, depending on what he does, and we'll say hello. So we're going to Loot Order, because what that does is it might bait out some sort of removal from him, or not, but it does allow us to Frostbolt that. Do we kill? We kill that. Either one, just drawing cards for him. He's burned a card because of it. I didn't actually think of that, but we can actually mill the guy, can't we? That's actually quite funny. He lost a Shadow of Death anyway. No great surprise that he has that in his deck. We know he's a good thin deck as well, so. Because we see what goes from here. Speaking of C'thun, okay. So we just want one to land on there. Come on. Oh well, I mean that's not so bad, is it? I could have popped down the other Flamewalker, to be fair. Never mind. Thing is, he wipes my board if I. I think we just drop this. because he can kill my Flamewalker, which I expect he will do. But does he know? We got one. Next time we can play the Faceless Summoner, perhaps, depending on what he plays. So the whole idea of this deck, as I said before, is just play your spells, get control of the board, and then when you kind of feel like it's the right time to slam down the Yogg. I usually find with Yogg, I mean it's... I usually find with Yogg that it is... like the best thing to do. This is the best play. Yeah, sure, why not? Okay, it's interesting. I mean, to be fair, 2/5 is pretty good. It means he can't kill anything without buffing this. Can't kill that, of course. So that's both his Shadow of Death's gone now. At least we know that. So he could struggle with removing big things now. I mean, this is just Flamestrike bait, isn't it, really? I can't see I'm going to get a better Flamestrike than this. The Colosseum Manager is an interesting card. I think it's pretty bad, but at the minute it's not terrible for us because it's something sticky on the board. Because I could do... What do I want to do? If I excavated evil... spellage, isn't it? Let's ramp up the spellage too. Now, Summoning Stone unfortunately does not work with Yogg-Saron, nor does the Flame Waker, because Yogg-Saron is the one casting the spells, not you. So closely, it says whenever you cast a spell. So that's important to note. Yep, he's very, everyone's always terrified of the Summoning Stone, and to be fair, rightly so, because it is a pretty terrifying card sometimes, especially if you're playing a deck with spells. But sometimes it's nice to put it down even if you don't have that many spells. Like at the minute, I don't really, I mean, I have the choice. I could chuck this guy down and then hope. I mean, what could I truly get that would be that good? Or I could Yogg. I'm gonna hope I get something. It's not really that good, is it? Yeah, I mean, I guess Cone of Cold. Sometimes you can get a little bit greedy with Yogg. You can just be like, has he got a way of getting it? Yes, he has. So I think now is the time that we Yogg. Unless, no, now's the time we Yogg. Hearthstone now. Definitely Spellbender. And then... Oh, for God's sake. Is this what we want to do? This would be interesting. He's got six cards left, so I would have thought the chance of him having his Cthune in his deck would be relatively high. Maybe he's getting a bit greedy. Oh, that's a good card. He must have his Cthune in his deck, I would have thought. Okay, that fireball came in a very good time, didn't it? Is a Yogg. Sorry, Cthune. Maybe he's got a Yogg as well, who knows? Nope. Still, he either still hasn't got it or he is just really trying to get the maximum out of it. Well, that's all his healing gone, I guess. So surely we're going to see a Cthune. To be honest, if you haven't got a lot of answers for a Cthune, I think I have another polymorph. But, yep. Oh, I thought he wasn't going to kill my Yogg then. So either we kill the Cthune, I mean we could freeze it to be fair. That's not a great thing. Worst case scenario, we drop a loot order and worst case scenario, we drop a loot order and shoot it. Yeah, because that's not gonna seal the deal. Oh God, that's not worked. Was it? so I doubt he would have been able to kill me. I think I would have won if I'd have had something to deal with that Cthun, but such is life. Interesting, isn't it? Wow, flame strike. Shame about the divine shields, of course. So I think what we do here is I'm gonna summoning stone. Mage or something like that, so. Let's get this rocket going. They have a better picture than us. I just think it's weird when, like, your opponent does something like that when they know you've got, like, a I don't know, it seems like a bit of a waste. I mean, I guess the idea is to get me to use my hero power and then do that, but I'm just trying to get cards, I guess. Doesn't really worry me too much. Because I'm getting cards as well. They've got 7, I've got 6. Only they've used more than me. Looks like he's got some multiple answers there. Yep, I was expecting a frostbolt of some sort. Expect not to get much on the board. That's interesting. I mean, I'm gonna frostbolt that, so some shoes. Oh, one shoe. Okay, well, I mean, that's just a fireball, isn't it? I think I don't want to play too much. This guy. Wow. I would imagine he's got 8 damage in his deck, so I think we're dead again. It's a little unfortunate, but I guess that's the way it goes. Yeah, I imagine he's just prepping up. He's thinking I can't kill him, so my hope is that Yorker comes out. But we've got a 1 in 18 chance of that happening. So actually, that's not true. There is something I can do. I could hope for some. Oh, that could save me. That might be a big one. I don't think. Don't want the Colosseum Manager anyway. Or Dumb Guard. At least it's golden though, because he was golden. he's on 15, so technically we've got 6. We could kill him next turn if he doesn't get everything on my board. We could only do 13 with what's on there. I was expecting a flame strike, to be honest with you. It's interesting that he hasn't got enough to kill me though. That's a shame. Anything with healing? No. Okay. Yes, Mirror Entity. Let's see what he plays. Hopefully it's some massive taunter. Understand how he hasn't got enough spells to do enough damage here. That's really weird. Because he's only got 3 cards left. Has he just got minions? Or that's fair enough. That's a shame. Would have been perfect if he got rid of that. So is he a Murloc deck? Ooh, that's interesting. I'm actually going to save this one because that could be very, very useful if I'm playing against Murlocs. Looks like I am. the same time, I'm not letting him get anything on the board. I'm also not getting anything on the board and running out of spells, so, you know. Is that it? Strike range now, so if he does, you know, try and dump a load on there, yeah, like now. We're still alright. Zero power is just like totally anti-Murloc. I think I had enough to kill him then anyway.